Good day, parents. My name is Olorifemi Elizabeth. I am here to recite my poem, which says, "No time for God." You have time to build houses and in them you dwell, and time to do business, to buy and to sell, but none for repentance or deep earnest prayers. To seek your salvation, you have no time to spare. You have time for earth pleasures, for folic and fun, for our glittering treasures, how quickly you run, but care not to seek to the fair mansion above, for the favor or the gift of God for his love. You have time to take voyages over the seas, and time to take in the world jubilee, but soon your bright hope will be lost in the bloom of cold, dark river of death, and in the tomb. You have time to resort to mountains, and time to gain knowledge from books and from men, yet no time to search for the wisdom of God. But what of your soul when you are in the grave? For time will not linger how helpless you lie. Staring death in the face, you take time. Then what of the judgment? Think, I implore. For time will be lost when you have no time for God. Thank you.
Good day. Good day, ma. Good day, sir. My name is Ayeni Esther. I'm here to recite a poem which says, "Let God." As children bring their broken toys with tears for us to mend, you brought your broken life to God because he is your creator. But then instead of leaving him in peace to walk alone, you walk around and try to help his ways that were your own. At last, you snatch them back and cry, "How can you be so slow, my child?" He said, "What could I do? Never did let God." Thank you.
Good day, ma. My name is Emmanuel Akiemi. I am here to recite a poem titled "Keep Your Heart." The heart of man is the true source of life. Whether life is righteous or unrighteous, it is the work of the heart. True religion begins with the heart. False religion also begins from the heart. The heart, therefore, is the ruling power of mankind. When the heart is corrupt, the tongue, life, and conduct will be corrupt. When the heart is clean, the life will be also clean, and the fruit good. It will also affect the tongue. If a woman or a man's heart is dark, he or she cannot do good because he or she is separated from God. So, above all others, keep your heart from going astray, for out of it is the issue of life. Your heart's feelings of love and of desire dictate a great extent of how you live, because we find time to do what you enjoy. Parents, write these 6 points down. Number one, make sure your affection push you towards God and righteousness. Number two, putting boundaries on your desire. Number three, being selective in what to pursue. Number four, keeping your eyes fixed on your goals. Number five, not getting sidetracked by sin. Number six, renewing your mind always with the word of God. Parents, keep your heart and you'd have kept your life. Thank you.
Good day, sir. Good day, ma. My name is Elise Elijah. I'm here to recite the poem, Mrs. Benson. You are capable of great things, but you must never forget that there's a hand guiding your step. We call that hand God, and he guides us according to his will. Sharpener makes the pen suffer a lot, but afterward is more sharper. So you must learn to bear certain pains and sorrow, because they will make you a better person. What really matters in the pencil is not the wooden exterior, but the graft inside. So always pay attention to what happens inside you, because they will manifest in the outside. The pencil always allows us to use an eraser to rub out any mistake. This means that connecting something we did is not necessarily a bad thing, but it keeps us to the road to purity and justice. The pencil always leaves a mark. In just the same way, you should know that everything you do in life leaves a mark. Just as so, try to be conscious of that in your every action, just as the pencil is you. Thank you.
Good day, sir. Good day, ma'am. My name is Manu Victor. I meant to recite a prayer titled "Give It to Get It in the Kingdom." As you listen, may God bless you. A king decided to reward his servant according to what they put in the vineyard. The servant competed in different ways. Some competed with shovels, while others competed with groups. The time for rewards came. The man took his servant to a house full of gold. They were to carry as much gold as they took could carry. Immediately, those who had rope exclaimed, "Master, I cannot carry the gold." And master said, "For with the same measure that ye met with that, you shall be measured with it again." Luke 6, verse 38. The moral of the story is obvious. You have a bountiful harvest, you must sow bountifully. God will also affirm it in 2 Corinthians 9, verse 6. "For this I say, he which sows sparingly shall reap sparingly, and he so bountiful shall also reap bountifully." You can give including your time, treasure, and talents. But for you giving yield a great harvest, you shall be characterized by the following qualities: excited, not reluctant; cheerful, not resentful; thoughtful, not haphazard; sincere, not hypocritical; sacrificial, not self-pleasing; bountiful, not meagre; discreet, not conceited; purposeful, not aimless; love, inspired, not vainglorious; unconditional, not with ulterior motive. Eternity, focused, not with earthly inclined; directed to the needy, not to the greedy or lazy; done in obedience, not in self-will. In a nutshell, you are not withhold anything from God, or shut up your bond of compassion from your fellow men. Tithe of involves donation must be paid accurately as when due. As you cultivate an attitude of generosity and start giving bountifully today, God's blessing upon your life knows no bound, in Jesus' name.
Wow. Hey, I thought I would have just to you.